Hello everyone, it's Mia, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create a model version of this sculpture right here. Now this sculpture was made by Anish Kapoor. You can look him up on Google, he is a very big artist. By big I mean famous. So this sculpture is located in Chicago, and I'm going to show you how to create a 3D model version of it on Rhino 3D. So this is going to be super easy, a few simple steps, and you'll get a model version of this that we can render in the next video. Let's get right into it. So this sculpture is a bit tricky because of its hidden shape. So as you can see, the general form looks like a bean, and the trick is that in here the shape kind of dips into itself. So what I want you to do is go ahead and search for this image on Google. You can type Anish Kapoor the bean blueprint and you'll find this picture. What we're gonna do is use this image to trace a curve. So before we start doing that, we're just gonna organize our layers. So we're gonna create one layer for the image so we can hide it when we need to. And we're gonna put large curve for the first one. And we're gonna put the image here in the image tab. So change the location, and we're going to start right ahead and click on the large curve so that now we're working on this layer. So we're going to create a line here. Let's change the color of this so we can tell the difference. I like to go for a red, so let's do that. And then we're going to start with the curve function here. So there we go. So now we just want to create this curve as accurately as we can. Now for this sculpture, it's okay to not be 100% because this is kind of like an exercise for this function that I'm going to show you, and also it's kind of approximate. It's okay. So here we go. So we just, as you see, I'm just tracing the outline. So this is what the inside looks like. And I know it's unexpected. So now we can get rid of this image. So we're gonna hide it. And we can get rid of this line. And then what we're gonna do is select the curve that we've just created, write symmetry in the command bar, and then select the top point. And the bottom point. Now we're going to want to smooth out the bottom. As you can see, it's a little spiky. So we're going to use the this command, and we're going to go for a 20 radius, and then just select both lines. And as you can see, it's not great. So just try with a number that's big enough so that you can't see this spike thing anymore. There we go. So that's quite good. Next step, we're going to want to create a 3D shape, right? So we want a cross-section line. So we're going to select both our curves and join them. There we go. And then, this is very important. So let me just... here we are. So, we're going to copy and paste this curve, click on this rotation line, and enter 90. So, you want to make sure that you do this in this order and not manually, because you want all the curves to be crossed, to cross each other, because they need to touch each other for the end command. So now we're going to work on the cross curve that we just created. So here on the side view. So we're going to select this curve and we're going to create some modifications. So we're going to erase some of these points because we don't need them. There we go. This also can be erased. Okay, that looks quite good. So now we're going to create the outside shape. Whoop. Here we are. There we go. It's a bit more steep than the other side. So like that. Maybe even let's erase this one. There we go, and then make this a bit steeper. There. That looks quite good. It looks a bit rounded still. I think it's a little steeper in reality. So here you can just adjust approximately. It doesn't have to be 100%. It's okay. Here, I think that's a little better. There, and okay. So now we're going to divide this curve here with a divide command. Select the curve, press enter, and then select this curve to divide it. There we go. And now you can select this longer edge, erase it, and then select this one, and just as we did with the other one, type in symmetry like that, and there we go. Okay, almost done now. We've got a couple more steps. So now we want to go to the perspective view. So here you can see that we're starting to get there. Yeah, that looks pretty good. And what we want to do now is use the curve option and just create a curve around that connects all four sides together at approximately the same height. It doesn't have to be exact. Again, it kind of looks like a chip like that. As you can see, I just selected some random points, just about the same height, and that'll do. And now you want to make sure that these two are cut in half. So what we're gonna do is cut and then select enter. So this one is now cut in half. Sorry, there are two. And then we're gonna do the same. Oh, this one is also cut in half already. Right, because we didn't join it. And now we're going to select the entire thing and go to network. Oh, sorry. Go to network surface. And here we are. We're going to accept. And there you go. That is Anish Kapoor's The Bean in a 3D model.